Hello viewers, I welcome you to another episode on this channel. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make a Birkenstock halfshoe pattern. People have been sending me a message on my DM asking me to make a video on that, so I'm going to share that in this video. Stay with me as I give you this simple tip. So firstly, we have to make sure we have our cardboard, ruler, our eraser, pencil, and then our angle ruler. These are the things we need to make this pattern. So firstly, we're going to take the measurement of the length of this last from the front. Basically, from here to here, most of us would leave 1 inch from here to here. This is where the pattern starts from. To avoid obstruction when the foot is going in into the shoe. So we're going to measure from here down to get the length of our pattern. So we're going to make use of, let's say, 8.5, so we have a strap. 8.5. So we're going to take a straight line. This will be our center line. So we are going to extend this line now. See what we have got here now. Then remember that our pattern has to end somewhere here. From here to here, I'm going to use 3.5 inch. You can use 3 inch depending on how curvy you want the pattern to be, but I'm going to use 3.5. So 3.5 will end here. So if you wash out from here down, which means you're going to add this 1 inch that we have removed here. We're going to add it. Another 1 inch here again. Next step is I'm going to measure from here to here 1.5 inch, from here to here 1.5 inch. So I'm going to make this pattern from one side. So I'm going to measure from this line to here 1.5 inch. Then I have to measure from here down here the length. That's where the curve or the length of the curve. So let's use 3.5. So I'm going to figure on the second line from here to here, 3.5 inch. So now we have almost gotten our pattern. So for here I'm going to measure five inch from this line to here 5 inch. So I'll now take this one here. Getting these, our cuts out. Now remember, this is our center line. I'm going to fold it into two places. Step the leads so that the pattern will move as I'm trying to cut it. So now I'm going to start cutting this. Yeah, you have all the stuff on the pin. Let's see on the last issue. Let's see what I've got here now. So I'm going to add at least. I'm adding at least 2 inch from here. 2 inch. So our oven is almost ready. So, see, it's because this is paper, I cannot begin to fold the forms, but our major aim is here. So, you see the curve. We have just a simple way to get this pattern. There's no stress about it. Just with this simple step, you can get the pattern. Thank you. See you next time.